So I want to tell you guys before we get started, my friend Brianne's going to like bring the heat. I love that about her. So I have had the most fun in the last 3 days because I've gotten these types of messages. I've got a friend, Tabitha. She sent me a message and it said that she had re-ranked Senior Ruby this month, which is huge. We've got someone that's really close to Emerald. I have another girl that ended last month at 270, and right now she's at 430, which I thought was just amazing. And so I'm getting on the jewels page, I'm getting on the diamonds page, and I'm seeing new diamonds, new sapphires, new emeralds. And it just brings me so much joy because I'm kind of snarky in my head. I have like an inner snarky voice. And so the first thing I do is I say, oh yeah, nobody has success in Plexus anymore. Like I'm talking to like this imaginary person, but really what I'm saying is like the opportunity is still alive and well for those that are willing to go for it. Those that are willing, like we talked about, to remove the rope, remember the elephant, or to move the boulder. Those people are going to experience that type of success. So Brianne, I'm going to be quiet so that you can do your thing. I told her, I said, could you just come be you for like 10 minutes or less? And she literally said yes and didn't ask any questions. So welcome.
Hello. Happy Thursday. No, it's Wednesday. Happy Wednesday. Y'all, I love living a life that it doesn't matter what day of the week it is. I mean, really, it's super true. I would do anything for Jen Lee. So if she messages me and she's like, hey, can you hop on? Legit, hands down, it doesn't even matter what it is, I will be there. So here's what I want to challenge you guys with today. And you'll hear me, some of you guys that have heard me speak before, you know I'm talking a little bit different. I have a little bit of a lisp going on. I just got done with an appointment. I am on an Invisalign journey. And so I just got done with my appointment where they put my brackets on my teeth and I've got all these things going on. And as I was sitting in the chair today, I was thinking, okay, I'm going to drive a little bit on the way home. So I'm sitting in my car. I can hop on. I can do this. And what an absolute blessing that we literally can do this business from anywhere. I don't think that that is ever a negative thing. I love that I can work from anywhere, that I can plug in for 10 or 15 minutes, that I can design my day, that I don't know what time of day it is or what day of the week it is. But while I was sitting in that chair, I kept thinking about the fact that a year ago this month, I was sitting in the chair and my dentist was going through with me and telling me the timeline of things. And at that time, I just didn't feel like it. I didn't feel like getting Invisaligns. I didn't feel like driving because I live in the middle of nowhere, y'all, like middle of nowhere. And so it is an hour both ways to my dentist. And I was like, nope, ain't got time for that. Don't want to do it. And then in December, he said to me, do you know what? If you would have started in March, because I was complaining, I was like, okay, now I got to do it. I got to get this done. He said, if we would have started this in March, you would have been done with this by now. And today when I was sitting there starting this, I was thinking, you know what? If I would have started this, I would have been done with it. He's completely right. I don't know. Show me in the comments, drop a one if you've ever had that, where it's like you look back in time and you kind of beat yourself up for a second. Like if I would have started that, I would have been done with it. If I would have clued into my business, I could be where they are right now. If I would have done X, Y, or Z, that's where I would be. And in that hot second, when we start thinking about it, we can kind of beat ourselves up and think, well, it's too late. Or you have the opportunity to sit there and be really grateful that today I got to start, that I had another chance to start again. I read this quote one time that it said, procrastination is the arrogant assumption that you will have another chance to do the things that God already gave you the time to do. I'm gonna say it again. Procrastination is the arrogant assumption that God will give you another chance to do the things that he's already given you a chance to do. So what is it for you today? Maybe you're sitting here and you're thinking, okay, it's the 30th of the month. I've been here, full vulnerability, full disclosure. I've been in a space at the end of the month in my business where I've thought, okay, well, I'm not where I want to be. And instead of having those people ordered today, I'm just going to wait until the first of the month. Anybody else ever felt like that? Drop a 2 in the comments if that's you. Or you think like, oh man, it's already the 30th. I really wanted that tablet, but I've only added 2 people this month. And so I'm going to wait until the first and see what the next thing is that's coming. Y'all, do not have the scarcity mindset in this office. I was doing a call with my team this morning and somebody was talking about that. Like, hey, is it better to wait until next month? It is never better to wait, because that life that you change today could be your next runner. You are one conversation away. You are one action away from a completely different business. And if you wait, that person might sign with somebody else. If you wait to do that action, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 it, right? Your brain does not know the difference. And this is going to sound real dramatic for a hot second. Your brain does not know the difference if you are about to message your dream teamer or you're about ready to step in front of a bus. Because in each situation, your brain is trying to keep you safe. Safe from getting yourself hurt if you step inside or step out front of the bus, right? Or keep your emotions safe because you don't know what's going to happen. And so every single day, every single minute, you have the choice. And so today, what I want to challenge you with right now, I want you to think, where do I want to be in 5 years from now? We live in a world of instant gratification, where this choice that I have right now, this brownie, it's going to taste really, really good, but it's going to last for 30 seconds. And at the end of that 30 seconds, I'm going to be left wanting more. Or I can choose to have a glass of water, even though it does not taste as good, because I know I'm going to feel better an hour from now. Those actions in your business, not wanting to get into your back office, not wanting to message your dream team, or maybe you had somebody that turned off their subscription and you know you need to follow up with them. You know you need to check in about life, but you don't want to do it because your brain is trying to keep you safe. Y'all, that is all we have heard over the last 2 years. Stay safe. Don't keep staying safe. Do the hard things. Because I promise you, and it has happened to me, I can tell you story after story in my life over the last 6.5 years with Plexus, where I've wanted to go to sleep after I've tucked my kids in. I have done this in every season of my life. My kids were 2, 3, and 5 when I started. My husband, we have a dairy farm. He was leaving at 3:30 in the morning, not getting home until 11. I was raising 3 kids by myself. I was working 2 jobs. And you better bet when COVID hit and we had to sell the cows, that I was so thankful that I plugged in the hard moments and that I chose to do the things that were going to last me years from now, because my husband didn't have to go and get another job. He didn't have to worry about the finances when we had to make hard decisions. It might seem right now that this is the hard, and I hope that more hard isn't coming, but it might. And I want you to be set up for success. Those people that you look up to in this opportunity, I want you to be them because you've set the standard for your team. So where do you want to be in 5 years from now? Where do you want to be in 5 months from now? And then look at your day. What are you doing in your day that's helping you align from those goals? Because y'all, you can tune in to every single Zoom. You can listen to the self-growth. But if you're not applying it and you're not doing it and you're not showing up for those moments and doing the hard things daily, you're not going to get where you want to be. And I don't want you to look back a year from now and wish that you would have plugged in a little bit more. Like, I wish I would have plugged in with these teeth and it was already over, right? Simple analogy, but I want more for every single one of you, because I'm a firm believer that there's not one type of personality that makes this opportunity work. It is for every single person. And I believe that with my whole heart. And if you're here and you're listening, it's because you have a purpose and you have a story that is ready to be told to other people. Don't be somebody different than you are right now. Plug in, do the growth, but somebody is waiting to hear your story. And we have 2 days left, y'all, like magic days in the land of Plexus. So do not stop doing what you know to be true in this opportunity. All right. I love you guys. I hope you have the best day. And I can't wait. I'm in your team pages, so I can't wait to see all the rank ups this month. It's going to be amazing.
Okay. Well, we love you and you're amazing. And I was like, how is she going to connect Invisalign to Plexus? And you did it. I was like, dang. Okay. There's so much here, but I want to say that this completely connects to what we're going to do right now. And this has to do with setting goals for April. Thank you, Brianne. You're amazing in every possible way. I'm going to upload the recording because people are asking for that to share with their team. So thank you so much, guys. All right. 2 convictions that I heard in that. One being avoidance. And I even do this. If I know someone's turned off their subscription or if I know something might not look the way I want it to, I avoid it. Well, go back to what she said. Scarcity says, I'll deal with that later. I'll save it for next month. I'm not going to address it. But I love that she said, how much further could you be if you would have just tackled that head on right away? So number one, I want to read you something. And then I want you to listen to this while we do some goal setting. Time out. If Heather Langford is on here, can everybody unmute and just literally lose their mind? Because Heather is senior gold and you have no idea. She just rank advanced this month and I am so senior proud of her. So act like lunatics and unmute if you're available. Hey, hey everybody. Hey. 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 It's the best.
Thank you, Jan.
You're welcome. I literally cried when I saw that. It's just this whole idea of you never know what's around the corner. And it's sometimes going to happen fast and sometimes it's going to happen at a pace that you're not excited about. But either way, success is coming. And I was just seeing that and I was just like, yes, I just so thrilled. I acted like a lunatic. Okay, so I'm going to read you this really quick and then I'm going to play it for you. Do you guys remember when we did the CTFAR? We were talking about that with Emily Gibson and I just put it here on like a Google Doc just to show you. Sorry, I've like got a million tabs open. It's so easy. The reason that I want you guys to be doing this is because one, I want you to end your month strong. But sometimes what we do is we put tunnel vision on just ending it. And then by the first, we're so tired and we're like, I deserve a break. Well, the problem is we need to set that month up for success. So let's kind of just do a little bit of thoughts around what is April going to look like. Guys, I didn't do anything. So I know for a fact we've hit the season, March and April, of the business having its natural upswing, just natural. That's just what happens. March and April tend to be really good months. And without any work of mine, I know that for a fact because I really didn't re-engage back until like 2 weeks ago. Everything's moving forward. People are ranking up. So you need to capitalize on this. So Emily Gibson just does CTFAR. So basically think about the circumstance that you want to happen in April. And you may have to walk through this a few times. You may have to write down the circumstance you want. Maybe it's you want to add 3 people. Maybe it's you want to help one of your level ones hit silver. Maybe you have a particular rank advancement. Whatever that might be, it could be a weight goal. There's so much. It could be like you earn the gala and you have a dress that you want to be able to zip up. Okay. Whatever that circumstance is, think of it and you're going to write it down. And then I want you to immediately think of something that you're thinking of when you think of that. So for example, I bought this crazy, weird green dress for the gala. I literally think it's the most beautiful thing I've ever seen, but I can't hardly zip it up. So my circumstance is I want to wear this dress, which is why I mentioned that. My immediate thought is that's going to take work. That was my immediate thought. That's going to take work. And then my feeling around that is, am I committed enough? Like, I don't know if I'm committed enough. And I start feeling less than, like other people could do it. And I don't know if I could do it. I start feeling less than. And as soon as I go down that road, my action is why bother? That's my action. And what's my result from that? I don't wear that dress. I can't wear that dress. So once I've done this, going through these steps and I see that result, I'm like, I don't want that result. So what does that mean? I have to figure out how to change the thought that will then change my feeling that will cause me to go into action to get the result I actually want. So you might have to do this a few times based upon the circumstances you're projecting for yourself for April. And heck, if you want it to be for the end of March, you could do that too. But before we do it, I'm going to make you guys listen to a song while we do it. But I want to read this to you because it's so good. I feel like, do you guys have this down, by the way? Circumstance, thought, feelings, action, result. That's what that is. Someone can put it in the chat too. Okay. I am a huge believer in doors being open for you. And I've always seen people when they come to Plexus have that same thought process where I think this is where I was supposed to be. I think this was the answer to the prayer that I had. I think this is what I'm meant to do. I feel like this is a calling. So I align myself with that way of viewing this business. So this song kind of fits that alignment, but it says, when all I see is a battle, you see my victory. When all I see is a mountain, you see a mountain moved. As I walk through the shadow, your love surrounds me. There's nothing to fear now. I'm safe with you. And then as you go a little bit more, this is the part where I get like crazy goosebumps. It says, and if you are for me, who could be against me? For Jesus, there's nothing impossible for you. When all I see are the ashes, you see the beauty. When all I see is a cross, God, you see an empty tomb. So when I fight, I'll fight on my knees. With my hands lifted high, the battle belongs to you. Every fear I lay at your feet, I'll sing through the night. The battle belongs to you. So I'm going to play this and I want you guys to walk through your April goals. And once we're done with that, we'll do other like work. Let me turn this on. Can you hear this? Hold on.
Shining.
love that song so much. I'm so glad you don't see me when I'm alone acting like I can really sing that song. So I'm going to share with you really quick kind of the what I walked through. And then I was hoping any of you guys that are willing to share would share, because I think it helps people to see someone else struggling with their nasty thoughts. I call them nasty thoughts because I'm like, ew, gross. Why in the world is my brain going there? Okay, so the circumstance that I wanted for April is to grow my reentry. So my reentry has sat at senior goal now for like a year. And at one point, I even got up to 400. But I've got this particular runner that is just amazing. She is so incredible, but she really hasn't been doing much lately, which I'm sure she's mirroring my activity. So my circumstance was grow my reentry and re-engage. I'm not going to say her name because I remember Stacy said I have to protect people's privacy. Okay, so I'm going to re-engage this lady. My immediate thought is, well, that's awkward. She's not interested anymore. She's bored with this. That was my immediate thought. And so then the feeling I got from that is, I must not be very good at this, that my level one would be bored with this and not interested anymore. So then the action that came from that thought was, maybe I'll work on my reentry later when I get better at this. Maybe I'll just do that later when I'm better, I have more skills. And so then the result is the growth doesn't come. Isn't that interesting how you walk through that and what that creates? Does somebody want to share what they kind of wrote down and walked through? Just unmute yourself. Okay, so I'm the only one willing to wear a bikini on the beach in front of everybody. Is that how that works?
Okay. I'll go.
Thank you. I'll go. Thank you.
I'm not happy about this.
That must mean you're meant to do it.
I know, that's the thing. Okay, so my circumstance is I have a friend who I just found out has Lyme disease. And her husband also lost his job. He's a PR guy was in local government. So they have no insurance. She's got Lyme. He's lost his job. So that just tells me, my thought is, I need to reach out about the business to them, but my feeling is a bit intimidated because we're not really that good of friends, but we're kind of marginally good friends. Mm-hmm. So what's the next one? My feelings. Okay. My feelings obviously is fear, scared. My action is, what I'm actually doing is I'm pulling together the things that I would need to do. But there's a level of procrastination too. So I'm slow walking it.
Yeah, well, and the funny thing is, I always tell the kids this, I'm like, eat the dang frog. Because what they do is they save the hardest assignments that they have for the end. They'll do all the easy stuff first. Right. But then you've got this monkey on your back just sitting there. And you're like, if I would have just done that first, I could have had a good day. It would have been awesome. So you know what's funny? And I'm just going to say this to give you some type of relief. There is no perfect wording and no scripting that's going to work. And here's how I know that. I have seen people stumble and say things that I'm like, ooh, that's terrible. And they actually get results. So what the truth is, you can't say the wrong thing to the right person, which is such a relief. Now, I also have trouble reaching out for the business because I don't like people thinking, well, she just wants me to make her money. So that is a struggle. But at the end of the day, my goal is for them to make money. That truly right.
For him to help his wife and for him and for them to be able to make their own money. I mean, they're a homeschooling family that I've known for way back, and they've got 8 kids and 6 are still home. So I know that money is important. Even if he goes out and finds a job tomorrow, he's been looking for 6 months. They still need the residual income that this brings.
Yeah. I mean, your heart is so good in it. And so you're just going to have to change that thought where I don't know them that well, and I have some fear about it. Instead saying, do I really need to know someone to tell them of something good? Like, I have literally given advice to someone on an elevator that I will never see again for the rest of my life.
And well, that's easier.
Is it? That's funny. I mean, I get what you're saying, because there is a guy in town. He's really great at business and everybody really respects him. And he wanted to get on a Zoom with me. And I immediately was like, he's going to know that I really don't know what I'm talking about. Like, it just felt this anxiety about it. But that's not what I'm here on this planet for, is to prove to people I know what I'm doing. I'm just walking through every open door. Like, that's all I can do. And that's my commitment, is I'm going to always walk through open doors. Okay, Leslie, thank you for sharing that. So what we need to do in order to close out business correctly is, I don't necessarily, now that we've changed the compensation plan or enhanced it, I don't really talk to the people that are less than 100 PV, because even when I tell them, oh, you could make commission on your own order, I know it's going to be like $1.50. Like, it just doesn't feel right. But if someone's at like 430, heck to the yeah, I'm going to message them and say, you realize if you ordered a bag of Slim, it basically would pay for itself, because of the fact that you're going to bump up to 25% commission. I think it's our job to make sure people don't fall through the cracks when it comes to getting a blessing, and that is a blessing. So I would check for anyone in your organization that's close to 500 PV. I would also check for anyone that's one away from silver. That's really, really important, because let's close them out so they don't have to wait till next month and those other two people have to reorder and like, what if they don't, and all of that. Let's just get her done right here in this calendar month. And then I would also encourage you guys to do a call to action post. I know some of you don't like them, but they work. So you've seen the whole looking for 6 friends to try my products at my cost. That works. I don't care what anybody says, it works. So if that's something that you feel like you're needing more people, more enrollments for the tablet or for a rank up, send that post to people in your organization and say, hey, if I were you, I would try this post. It really works. So be prepared if they start getting people commenting to get into chats with them. But those are things I would work on. I'm going to put it in the chat for you guys to see what I just said. Hey, go ahead and ask your question.
Hi there. Here's my question. So I have a girl who at the beginning of the month was so excited about earning a tablet. She's pretty new on my team. She got 2 pretty fast, but I feel like now all of a sudden, like, she's really like, she posted that magic post that I know you're talking about, but she got nothing from it. I mean, the only people that really commented on it were just my Plexus sideline sisters. And here's the thing. Her grandmother just was in the hospital. She just got a new, she just promoted in her job. She's like a supervisor now. And it's one of those where I don't want, I reached out to her yesterday and I said, I could do a messenger event for you. Like, you just need one more. Like, it would just be so good and da, da, da. But I don't, I'm almost afraid that if I go back to her again today and say something, that I could push her over the edge just because she's had so much going on. Like, I don't want to do that either. Like, I don't want her to shut down. But I mean, what do you do in this situation? What do you recommend?
Okay, so my immediate thought when you were saying all that is, this is a mindset issue. And I know sometimes people are like, it is not, I'm just busy. But the truth is—
No, I agree.
If it comes down to she needs one more, there's so much there. It could be one, fear of this is getting real. Like, if I do this, am I actually in this? Like, this is embarrassing. Like, am I willing to make this commitment? Like, that, if I do the one more and she puts a graphic out saying that I'm a silver ambassador, like, is there any going back from that? Like, what if my neighbors see that? What if people from work see that? So there's probably some mindset issues involved in that. And I don't know what your relationship is with her, but usually when I bring it up to people and they are not doing it, it's in their court, but I will ask the hard question. And this is how I would
say. Jack's up.
I gotta mute. Okay. I would ask this. Hey, whenever somebody's one away and it hasn't happened, I always ask this question because you know I'm here to help you in every possible way, but is there anything holding you back? If there was anything holding you back, do you feel like you could talk to me about it? And that is a really good way to get them to know that this isn't just about, hey, I need to ask you what's in the slim, or oh, how many points do I need for this or that? Or they're not asking you just plexus questions. This is actually about that relationship. So it's almost like coaching, and you don't have to have any answers. You're just asking her questions. So that's my tip.
Thank you. I like that.
Can you repeat the question?
Yeah, this is just across the board all the time. If somebody's stalling out, I would go to them and say, hey, as a friend, I just wanted to ask you a question. Is there anything that you know of that could be holding you back? Or is there anything holding you back? And that's something that if they are like, I don't know, what do you mean by that? Then you could share, well, I know when I was at this stage, whatever, you can name an experience you had, I started to feel fear. Like, what if people judged me? Or what if this or what if that? And I know that held me back for a while. And it made me wonder, do you have anything like that going on? Sometimes you're the lighthouse. You're the one shining the light on those thoughts that they probably know are there, but don't understand how much they are a hindrance to them. So just asking them what's holding them back. If they don't understand that question, tell them about a time that's happened for you. And then they're like, okay, I see what she's talking about. And if they don't know, say, that's fine. Think about it. Get back to me. I think it's a really powerful question. When you stand in that place of authority so that you're there to help them guard that gate of their thoughts, that's the greatest gift you can give someone in plexus, in my opinion, because I want them to have product results. I want them to make money. But when they learn a whole new way to guard their mind, that's invaluable. Okay, so I'm gonna answer a couple questions and I'm gonna show you something which will totally violate people's privacy. Look, I can't help it. Okay, number one, the shout out post is essential. And Alita's team, and she's now my primary leg, that is what they do with zero reservation, zero awkwardness, immediately out the gate. Okay, so if you just treat it like it's no big deal, then it's no big deal. Just do it. And so the way that Heather told you guys to post exactly what she wrote, that's perfect. And you can tell people, edit it to make it sound most like you, but don't overthink it. It's always nice to get free products. So I want to show you something that we just started doing today, and so far so good. And it's just an idea. So I have a girl that's really close to Ruby, and she and I were talking about, they've added 40 people this month, which is literally insane, I think, like for the level that she's at. So what we did was I said, hey, I want you to make a chat that's called Welcome to Plexus, and I want you to put everybody that's joined your team. And so she did right here. I'm sorry, I'm violating privacy. Then what I did was, is I started it off and I just basically told them why we're having this chat. And I wanted it to be a place where they could ask questions and be encouraged as they get started with the products. So all these people that joined in March are now in this chat. And I said, two things to get you started. Watch this quick video. And then can you share a goal that you have with Plexus? And I incentivized that. And I said, I'll pick one of you to win a free bag of the new Plexus Lemon Lime Hydrate. So they kind of wanted to share more. So this is a 1 minute video that I made for a Messenger event party a long time ago that basically tells, and it was really hard to be that fast, but I did it. It has to be a minute or less to be able to send through Messenger at that time. So anyhow, it just is a really super quick video. And they've never met me. I have no idea who these people are. They don't know what a diamond is. They, like, I'm just a person that happens to know their upline. Immediately we started getting people commenting what they were looking for. So I kind of just gave them a little love on it. I don't like Messenger threads that dump all this information out, and a person would literally have to sit down with a cup of coffee on their front porch for 30 minutes just to be able to read through everything you sent. And are they going to do that? I don't know. So people are all commenting their goals. So here's this next girl sharing her goals. Other people start sharing their goals. We're commenting on the goals. And I come back in and say, one of the girls shares what Plexus has done for her just in the last 3 weeks and how much she loves it. And I said, we need to share your story on the Plexus testimony page. And then I said, make sure all of you are on it. So then I gave them the link to the page I wanted them. This is their closest page. So I gave them that to make sure they're in it. This next guy comes in and says, I've ordered it. Here's my goal. Then I say, this is my YouTube channel that has some instructions for how to use the product. So I give them that. More people are sharing their goals. And then towards the bottom here, which I totally have a typo, this is more people just sharing their goals, sharing their goals, sharing their goals. Right here, I made a poll. And of course, I have a typo and it's driving me crazy. I said, who here wants their products to be free? Me or I like to it for them? It's supposed to say I like to pay for them, but it's going to bother me forever. But anyhow, so far, three people have said, me, I want my products to be free. These are brand new people. So I'm going to give them the shout out post and an example of what that would look like and tell them to get busy doing that. Because really, if they get started now, if I can get them to silver now in the last 2 days of the month, that's amazing. So that's just a suggestion. If you have new people and you create that kind of chat, that's just a way for you to get people plugged in, one-stop shopping. What was that video about? So the video was like, my name is Jennifer. I've been with Plexus for 8 years. I joined because I wanted to lose weight. And this is what happened. And then I decided to start sharing. And in the past 8 years, my family's made over $3.5 million. And I just like, as fast as you could possibly imagine a person could talk, and I can do it. But I just really quick as I could in 1 minute, told what my experience had been with Plexus. It's almost like I'm third party for them because I'm not their, I am their upline, but they don't know that. Okay, so I'm just picking one person from everyone that shared their goals, and I literally just randomly pick it. Like, there's just no rhyme or reason to that. And then I was going to share this with you before we kind of wrap up. Brianne said something, and I wrote this down and underlined it. She said, you're just one conversation away from a completely different business. And it got me thinking about my friend Latoya, who, again, I'm violating privacy. And Latoya joined Alita the day Alita joined. They were best friends. Alita showed up. They worked at her husband had a car mechanic shop. She showed up at her office and said, get out your computer. You're signing up to do this with me. And so Latoya joined. Alita and her ran together for like the first 5 months, ran. And then it was like something happened. It could have been a mindset thing. It could have been an overwhelm thing. It doesn't matter. But Latoya kind of stopped. And for 5 years, she stopped, y'all. 5 years. And the whole time she was still getting paid by Plexus because she had built up to a senior gold team. And it kind of went down a little bit, but people were just still ordering. And Alita was still kind of talking with them, and the people loved their product. So she was still making a check every single month, which amen to that. I mean, come on. That's what I'm talking about. And eventually, Latoya decided when they did the compensation plan enhancement, she really liked what she was hearing. And I also think she was in a good place. She started doing coaching, identified all of these things that were actually in her mind, the nasty thoughts, the mind trash that was holding her back. She really committed to do the business again. And Alita asked her, tell me the one person that you want to do this with you. Like, who is that one person? And she said, I want Danielle, my pastor's wife. She said, okay, we're going to send her a message right now. And so remember what Brianne said, your brain doesn't know if you're about to get hit by a bus or you're just doing something bold. So Latoya felt like she was being hit by a bus, but they wrote that message and sent it to her. And of course she's a pastor's wife. So they sent the Krista Deary. Do you remember when I did the Meet Plexus event with Krista Deary and there's like 6,000 views because she's amazing. They sent that video and Danielle says, okay, you've piqued my interest. She said, what are the products? And so they told her, and Danielle proceeded to do Fast Start Senior Ruby. Did you just hear me? Fast Start Senior Ruby. You are one conversation away from a completely different business. Latoya for 5 years was not working. And then she was ready. She had the right conversation with the right person. And now look at her. She's almost emerald. I'm sorry, but that just gave myself goosebumps because that is incredible. Everything is just one away from something new and different and amazing. All your dreams, all your goals, all your CTFAR is just one away. You just have no idea who God has planned for you. You have no idea. And that should be a part of your everyday prayer. I am committed to saying, God, I have no idea who you're going to bring, but I trust you. And when they do come, I'm going to do the best of my ability with your help. And so you just need to be praying for that person that's going to be coming, and he will provide that. That's the good news. You don't have to have a feeling of scarcity or fear or I got to find them. No fear. They're coming. They're all coming. And you just be prepared to walk through the open doors. So I will see you guys on Monday. It'll already be April. Save the date, April 15th through May 6th. We're going to do the Slim and Ease Challenge. It'll be one bag of Slim, 2 bottles of Ease, which means it's a custom welcome pack if someone's new. And they're going to take so much Ease, they're not going to know what to do with themselves. I think it's 6 a day or something. But I don't know if you saw the before after pictures that are coming out from the challenge they just finished. They're letting us join in the second round. Oh my gracious. It's like, it's insane. So save the date and I will see you guys. What's the video you're asking me for, Kathy? Oh, is it the Meet Plexus with Krista Deary? Okay. Give me just a second. If you want to get off, get off. Otherwise, sit here and stare at me staring at my computer while I'm looking for this video. It won't take me but a second. Okay.
What's the challenge called that you have coming up? What's it called?
Cheryl's the one who's, okay, hold on. Give me a second. It's going to come to me. I think it's called Spring
into Slim and Ease.
Oh, and it's Slim Ease, and it's Slim Active and Ease.
Nope, just Slim and Ease.
Oh.
One bag of Slim, two bags of Ease. No, sorry. One bag of Slim, two bottles of Ease. And okay. Then what we do is we
just a few questions.
In a second.
I can save you some time. I've had over 30,000 drinks.
Okay. Why does that have a commercial at the beginning of it? Does that mean I'm getting paid for that?
You have to pay to not have the commercials.
Oh, like, okay. Okay, so like YouTube's using my video to make money for themselves?
Yeah.
That's annoying. Okay. There's a video with Krista Deary. So every day we have giveaways. And so the giveaways are bags of Active. That's the only giveaway for the whole thing. And this is what Cheryl and her Jules have done this last month. She invited me to do it with her. And they're just having such great results. And the best part is people are coming on and saying what's happening for them. And it's almost acting like a post within itself because people are advertising it themselves. They're like, I'm only on day 8 and I just need to show you guys this. Look at my face. And so that really helps kind of encourage people to keep going. So bags of Active are the giveaways. Yeah. And if you're already an existing person, just Slim and two bottles of Ease. And maybe we just make a graphic. Maybe one of you guys can work on that, that says best tips for Ease. And maybe you say to them, some people keep it in the freezer or the refrigerator. If the shelf is, I can't say the word, shellfish smell, maybe don't say odor or smell. I don't know how you want to say that in a professional way. I'll leave it up to you and your amazing minds. But there's just ideas for Ease that, you know, take it in the morning or at night because your stomach isn't full and it allows it to have its best effect. Just instructions for Ease would be pretty helpful. We could put on there. Scent. Thank you, Leslie. I knew somebody would know a good word for that. Yeah, and I'm going to take like 50 Ease a day for the whole 3 weeks. And I'm going to look like Kim Kardashian when I'm done. Okay. I'm going to see you guys on Monday. It was awesome seeing all your faces. Go blast that song in the car and drive around and you're going to feel like $1 million. That one we listened to at the beginning. All right. Bye, guys.